March 23, 2016, Wednesday, Singapore. This terrapin came in 2 days ago at 91 grams. Now it's 89 grams after surgery to excise the 2 swollen ears, 2 ear abscesses. As you can see, the cut, there's a cut there, about 4 millimeters. The pus were all dried pus, and they were evacuated by Dr. Daniel. So now the swelling has gone down a bit. It's swollen, but this is due to the bleeding hematoma. And the other side also, the other ear as well, has been incised and drained as well. You can see the cut, about 4 millimeter, to drain out the pus. There you see a reddish line below the red stripe. There's the ear, the location of the ear, and it's 2 days, so the swelling has not increased, so the terrapin can go home today with antibiotics. Overall, this terrapin, the shell is good. As you can see, there's no white spots on the shell compared to the other one in another video where the shell had a lot of white spots. This is a normal shell, only that the ears are swollen with pus. So it should be going home today, and the swelling will go down over time, maybe 2 weeks. So it's the water must be changed every day. And for those who put terrapin in small tanks like this, water has to be changed every day. Otherwise, the dirty water with bacteria gets into the ear canal. Toa Payoh vets, ear abscesses in a terrapin, Singapore. 2 days after surgery to lance and evacuate and curate the abscesses. The terrapin has a red line there, and the swelling is due to blood clot. You should go down after 2 weeks. You can see the swelling, both sides, left and right side. Now this shell is good. Yeah. Good color. There's no white spots, but some scratches. Yeah. This terrapin is probably about 6 to 12 months old. Toa Payoh vets, 2 days post operation of ear abscesses, Singapore, March 21, 2016.